Okay. You know, Coach, just overall thoughts on tonight's contest?
Well, I certainly turned the ball over far too many times to beat a Pac-12 team. And we didn't block out. And that, those two things really hurt us. You know, the 28 points they got off of the turnovers and 42 in the paint. I can win many games against anybody with those kind of numbers.
Held them from the three, what do you think your defense tonight?
Our defense was great, except for we let 24 get loose, and that was our main goal, was not let her go off from three. So, you know, I love the defense on everybody but her. You know, she's a good shooter when she's left alone, like she was tonight. But I thought we did a great job on the other guys for a majority of the game. You know, probably about a good 35 minutes, but we had a 5-minute gap where they made us pay heavily with turnovers and with losing motion.
Kept it pretty tight in the first half, but then they kind of started to break away in the second half. What do you think was the difference there?
They started pounding down our throats. You know, our inside guys couldn't handle them inside. And then we started turning turnovers that led to their layups. And they shoot 60% in the second half. But when you're shooting layups and you're putting, shooting the ball 2 feet away from the basket, then it's easy to shoot 60%. So good, smart move by them to go TCU on us and just, you know, jam it down our throat. They saw the film. We were afraid that was going to happen, and it did.
They spread the minutes out a little more amongst players, whereas you had four girls near 30 or over 30. Do you think that kind of impacted play and then having some more fresh legs on the court?
I don't know, possibly. Our kids are in great shape. They're used to playing these kind of minutes. But again, in practice, other people are going to have to step up for us, and they're going to have to prove that they're ready to play at this level, you know. And, you know, in our program, if you can't get it done in practice, you're not going to get your time on when the lights come on, that's for sure. So, you know, I'm looking for improvement from these guys, from our bench, so they can get in and give those guys some rest. But right now, unfortunately, we're kind of where we're at with them. And it's a learning process for our new guys on the bench. And, you know, it's been a difficult transition for them. But I'm confident that as the season goes along, they'll be able to, you know, come up to the level and that they need to get minutes.
Here's moving into fourth, three in the three-pointers tonight. Any comments on her tonight? And friends a little bit too with the three?
Who do you want me to comment on?
Taylor.
Pierce.
Oh, yeah, Taylor. You know, Taylor had some really great looks early too, man. I was amazed. She missed a couple early. You know, those are her shots. She's been shooting the ball great. She shot the ball really well down in L.A. and then shooting the ball really well in practice last couple days. So, you know, trying to get her loose, trying to get her the shots. You know, I thought she had a good game, as well as obviously Michaela. You know, he had some turnovers there, but she had the ball in her hands a lot. I think there was too much ball watching from the other guys tonight besides Taylor. You know, I think Taylor and Michaela came out and played their games. The other guys stood around and watched a little bit. I thought Allie, Kirby, you know, had a good game for a freshman playing against Pac-12 for the first time.
Any thoughts on the crowd, the boys, and the atmosphere?
I thought it was great, you know, and I wish we would have, you know, kind of got ahead in that second half and really had them bring them into the game. You know, there were stretches where we did, and, you know, it was nice to just have that kind of crowd. You know, of course, certainly love to see more students come out. I'm not sure why students don't come out for our games, but, you know, love to have some student support, which would be fantastic. So that's disappointing that we didn't have that student support, other athletic team support tonight. But other than that, everybody that showed up, I hope they come back, you know, because I know we play a lot.
Yeah, does that do anything for you or the players?
Oh, absolutely. You know, you feed off that. And then we made those couple of those runs. I think they felt it. They, you know, they know the crowd was getting behind them. And we just couldn't quite get going enough, you know, to put them away. I thought when we went up four in that first half, you know, near the end, you know, we could have really ended on a high note, but then we turned it over a couple of times, got some bad fouls.
So is that any motivation going forward, improving games?
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, we love for everybody to, you know, keep coming and us to get better. You know, we get in conference, we're going to need that fan support. You know, we want to have a real home court advantage. Other teams in our league in particular, you know, Montana's, North Dakota's in this league, they got great home support, and we need to have that same home court advantage. Montana State's won 28 home games in a row, and it's because they get great crowds and their students come out there. So, you know, hopefully we can mirror that. you know, have a great Big Sky season.